U.S. Army and Navy, successful test launch of its Joint Hypersonic Weapon System. At the Wallops Flight Test Facility in Virginia on October 26, the U.S. military carried out a successful test launch of a rocket for the development of hypersonic weapons. The rocket carried 11 experiments to test and gather information for hypersonic weapons development to support the Joint Army-Navy effort. This was the second test conducted as part of a program to enhance land and sea-based hypersonic capabilities. According to a statement from the Navy, hypersonic weapon communications and navigation equipment, as well as advanced materials, were assessed to test whether they could withstand the heat in a realistic hypersonic environment. In this test, a sounding rocket was fired from the launch pad and conducted various experiments to gather data and learn more about the high-tech electronics and heat-resistant materials used in hypersonic missile components. "The launch went extremely well," said Vice Admiral Johnny Wolf, the Director of Strategic Systems Programs who oversaw the test. "We've just gotten done looking through our key observables, and every piece of data we wanted to collect, at least preliminarily, has shown that we collected all that data," he added. Pentagon is readying for hypersonic deployment. The recent test validated the future aspects of the Navy's conventional prompt strike, CPS, and the Army's long-range hypersonic weapon, LRHW. While the U.S. Army announced that the LRHW would be fielded in 2023, it also stated that the deployment would be preceded by several rounds of different types of testing. The system, which is said to have a reported range of 1,725 miles, is described in a Congressional Research Service report titled "The U.S. Army's Long-Range Hypersonic Weapon." It reportedly consists of a ground-launched missile with a hypersonic glide body and related transport, support, and fire control equipment. The land-based, truck-launched weapon is said to be armed with hypersonic missiles with a top speed of more than 3,800 miles per hour. Along with working together on the long-range hypersonic weapon, the U.S. Army and Navy are also developing a common hypersonic glide body that will be used by the Navy's conventional prompt strike hypersonic weapon. In 2025, the Navy will deploy its first live rounds while the Army purchases a second long-range hypersonic battery. The common hypersonic glide body is transported in a nose cone by a large rocket booster as part of the hypersonic weapon. The rocket releases the common hypersonic glide body once it has reached a significant altitude and speed. The common hypersonic glide body then descends toward its target at hypersonic speeds. The missile can reach the top of the Earth's atmosphere and stay there until it is ready to hit, at which point it will be too late for air and missile defense systems to intervene. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.